So there's audio now. Hey everybody, Dave Rollins here. So in this video, I want to go over my favorite film stock, or at least at the moment, my favorite film stock, which is Kodak Ektachrome. So this is a color reversal film, and it is rated as ISO 100, and I want to go over my exposure that I use for it. So I use ISO 80 most of the time, and I tend to lean towards one-third all the way up to maybe even a stop of overexposure depending on the scene. So I want to have like kind of a little bit of an exposure guide for everybody and show some examples so you can see, oh, okay, in that instance it would be good to expose, you know, one stop over. And there's a lot of instances where Ektachrome looked best at one stop over. So without further ado, let's go ahead and dive on in. I'll show you some examples of photos I've taken, and some are specifically for this video, and some are just because I love Ektachrome. So here we go. So this first test addresses some of the color issues that some people have had with Ektachrome. I tend to use an 8-12 filter when I shoot Ektachrome because it's a little bit too blue and too green most of the time. So this adds just a hint of magenta and a little bit of warmth and can really help, especially on an overcast day, as you can see in this image here. It was rainy that day and the overcast was just yielding a lot of blues. All right, so now diving into some exposure examples. I did some bracketing so we could take a look at what some overexposure would do to the same scene. This is a normal exposure, and here is one stop overexposed. And you can see this changes our color tonality so much. In these three images, here's one stop underexposed, normal exposure, and one stop overexposed. So you can see the film can really handle quite a bit. In this instance here, if the shadow detail was important, I would do one stop over and just let the truck go a little hot. In the power lines here, I like the normal exposure, but the one stop under yield really rich colors. So it just depends on how much detail you wanted in the shadow portions of the scene. As you can see here, a normal exposure has a decent bit more. One stop over is blowing those highlights, but you're getting some shadow detail. All right, moving right along. We got a fast pace here. This next test shows third stop increments. So we're assuming our base ISO is 80 ISO. So here is one stop underexposed, two-thirds of a stop underexposed, one-third of a stop underexposed, normal exposure, one-third of a stop overexposed, two-thirds of a stop overexposed, one stop overexposed, one and one-third stops overexposed, one and two-thirds stops overexposed, and two stops overexposed. Now here's some examples shot on Ektachrome, mostly 4x5. I tend to shoot a lot of 4x5 Ektachrome and only a little bit of the 35mm, although lately I've been just blowing through rolls of 35mm Ektachrome. It is so much fun, especially since I started mounting them and projecting them in my living room. The exposure latitude of Ektachrome is great. I'm not saying that it has the exposure latitude of negative films, but I'm able to get away with a little bit more overexposure than I ever was able to with the Fujifilm Provia or Velvia films. I loved both of those, but I just have a special place in my heart for Ektachrome at this point. Especially when processed in the CineStill chemistry, it just turns out so amazing.
All right, thanks everybody for tuning into this video. Please subscribe if you're enjoying these videos. I'm gonna have more coming out soon. And I don't wanna just put out content for the sake of putting out content, so I'm not extremely consistent about getting a video out every week, but I am hoping to have more coming out soon. I've got a number of videos that I've filmed and I just need to do intros like this for them. So thank you everybody for tuning in. I wanna always remind everybody, photography is a community, not a competition. So get out there, have some fun, shoot some photos,
And, you know, reach out to other photographers. I've met some of the most amazing people and made the most amazing friends through photography. So thank you, everybody, who comments on my videos or who tunes in. There's a beautiful community on Instagram that I really enjoy, so that tends to be where I show my work. I'm working on a book project right now too, so hopefully next year I'll have all the photos done for that. Anyways, again, thank you everybody for tuning in, and take care. Until next time.